It's the most god-awful time of the year. Christmas gifts have been opened and already broken, and I need a beer. It's the most god-awful time of the year. It's the crappiest season of all. The kids are too lazy to shovel the driveway, and here comes the plow. It's the most crappiest season of all. There's no parties to go to, there's nothing you can do. Winter seems to drag on. Just a few days ago, Christmas trees glowed, and now they're out on the lawn.
This thing is dead already? What a waste of $80.
It's the most god-awful time of the year.
KHJ Los Angeles.
Portions of the day's programming are reproduced by means of electrical transcriptions or tape recording.
You're listening to the radio.
Beef jerky time.
Vielen Dank für Ihre Aufmerksamkeit.
That is so stupid.
Getting drunk in the morning. Who are you, Kathy Lee Gifford?
We may not hook up with women, but we really understand women.
Hey, do you hear that?
What?
Well, it sounds like
birds. Yeah, birds.
Those are birds.
Birds are stupid.
Folks eat birds are stupid. Birds know who they can trust, know who love them.
Hey, it's January 5th, and if you didn't already know, today is National Bird Day.
Today? A whole day?
National Bird Day today.
We will dedicate the rest of this broadcast to
birds, birds, birds.
Showtime.
This show's going to the birds. The Mike Show. So darn happy you could join us right here, right now on Radio 434, the Radio 434 apps. And radio434.com. We're also on the Alexa.
Hello!
There she is. How do you get our live show and our feature channel on Alexa? Well, you simply go on over to your Alexa device and you enable the skill. One time you say, Alexa, enable the Radio 434 skill. And she will.
Hello! Mm-hmm.
And then after that, every time you want to listen on the Alexa, you just say, Alexa, play Radio 434. Very simple. You can also get our podcast on the Alexa as well. That's even easier. You just say, Alexa, play the Mike Show VA podcast. Because we're on the Amazon Music. We're on the Apple. We're on the Spotify. We're on the RSS.com. You can also get us on our website. We've got a link to it at radio434.com. Our modern alternative channel is our home for the live show. So when you're listening to the live show, you're also going to listen to some of the best new music first before it gets played over and over and over and over. Plus, we've got some really, really cool vintage tracks, stuff from way back into the 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s. Really, really cool stuff. So give it a listen. The live show and our live feature channel, either on the Alexa or at radio434.com. Okay. So, oh, yeah, and by the way, you can, if you're listening and you didn't know that you can watch the show segments, you can do that on our Facebook Live. If you go to The Mike Show VA, all one word, no spaces, The Mike Show VA on the Facebook, you can watch each of our show segments, sans music. All right, finally Friday edition. I want to thank Just Us Band for joining us last night at Three Roads. We had a rockin' good time. Really, really cool. Jason Dickerson, I think he and or the Pinchers are going to be joining us. The Pinchers are going to be joining us next week for our Mic'd Up Pop-Up Concert Series. That is each and every Thursday for Happy Hour from 5 to 7. At Three Roads at their Lynchburg, downtown Lynchburg taproom, 1300 Court Street. So come on out and join us. If you missed last night, you missed a fantastic time. Although we had a crap ton of viewers to the video that we shot. the videos that we shot. We reached over 9,000 people on the video. The first video we posted, we reached over 9,000 people watching. It was basically sound check is what they were watching. And loving it, obviously. So the Just Us Band, you can, if you go onto our Facebook page at the Mike Show VA, you can watch and listen to last night's show. But man, oh man, if we could have 9,000 people hitting Three Roads and joining us at the event, man, oh man, we would have been rocking the block. We would have had to put speakers outside. Anyway, all right. Coming up on today's program, since it's Friday, now we're going to get smart with five random facts. We're going to get really, really smart with nerd news. It's this weekend science. It's just science. Don't be afraid. Then we're going to get really, really dumb with your stupid criminals in dot news, plus your not headline news and our top list. Did you know that according to Tinder, the first Sunday in January is dating Sunday. It's the busiest day of the year for online dating. So we're gonna talk about that. Plus, we're also going to talk about our top list, top phrases that are red flags on a dating profile. All right? That is all on the way. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by your YMCA.
This is Ed. Ed loves the Y. Ed's buddy joined the Y because Ed told him how great the Y is. Now Ed and his buddy both save 20% off of their monthly dues. Ed and his buddy are getting healthy together. Ed refers his other buddies to the Y too. Now Ed and two of his best buddies are saving on their monthly membership. And you can too. Not a member? Join today with a friend and you'll both save like Ed. Be healthy, be active, be like Ed. Refer a friend to the Y and save.
It's the Rodora Warehouse Sale, Saturday, January 6th. Their flash sale brings you incredible discounts, but only for a limited time. 8 a.m. until they completely sell out of their amazing markdowns. Clothing, accessories, holiday items, decor, and so much more. It's all going on this Saturday, January 6th, 8 a.m. until it's all gone. Rodora Warehouse Sale at Rodora Specialty, 1103 Church Street, downtown Lynchburg.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
Hey,
you like Tinder, but you do wish it was designed more for your specific tastes. You've always had a thing for freckles, pale skin, and Irish surnames. So now from the creators of Tinder, it's an app exclusively for carrot tops and the people who love them. Introducing Tinger, where the gingerbread ginger breed. If you've developed a case of gingivitis or have a burning desire to get some fire crotch in your life, get caught red-handed on Tinger.
Wait a minute. The only guy on here is Ed Sheeran.
If you love Ed Sheeran or that kid from the Harry Potter movies, you'll love Tinger. It's Tinder for gingers.
It's where redheads go to find their soulmates.
If they had souls.
Tinger.
If they had souls. The Mike Show. So darn happy you could join us on the Finally Friday edition. So, clear that out. According to Tinder, the first Sunday in January is what they refer to as Dating Sunday. It's the busiest day of the year for online dating. Now, on Dating Sunday, they see an extraordinary surge in people updating their bios, uploading photos, sending messages, and responding to messages. In fact, Tinder said that people respond to messages 19.4 minutes faster on Dating Sunday than any other Sunday of the year. Now, they didn't explain why, but it's probably a mix of fresh starts for the new year, New Year's resolutions to find somebody, and the start of the more available time, you know, after months of holiday gatherings and being around other couples. By the way, this isn't just Tinder. A few years back, somebody from Match called Dating Sunday the Super Bowl of dating apps. So, interesting. So if you're out there and you're looking, well, this might help. According to Tinder, Sunday, as we mentioned, is the busiest day for online dating. So many Mr. and Ms. Rights out there, we'd hate for you to waste time on Mr. and Ms. Wrong. All right? Which is why we compiled a list. It's today's top list, top phrases that are red flags on a dating profile. Okay, we ready? Everybody ready? Okay, here we go. All right, get your pen and paper out, or a number two pencil, and take notes, or
dictation.
Anyway, top phrases that are red flags on a dating profile. Single and ready to mingle. Okay, so it's more like alone with nobody to bone. Yep. Top phrases that are red flags on a dating profile. I want loyalty. This is a dating app, lady, not a dog rescue. Okay. Top phrases that are red flags on a dating profile. What do you got to lose? Based on your beard braid, your reputation, and good taste. Top phrases that are red flags on dating profiles. Send me nudes. Let me guess. This is your first time on Christian Mingle. Top phrases that are red flags on dating profiles. My name is Xander with an X. That's it. Just my name is Xander. Deal breaker. Top phrases that are red flags on dating profiles. I'd rather meet up in person than text. That's spoken like every guy who winds up in prison at the end of Dateline. Top phrases that are red flags on dating profiles. I haven't dated much since my best friend Jeffrey hung himself in prison. It's pretty self-explanatory. Top phrases that are red flags on dating profiles. I'm fluent in sarcasm. Me too, so please tell me more. Top phrases that are red flags on dating profiles. I hate cats. Special thank you to listener T. Swift for that submission. Here we go. The Mike Show. Your top list. Coming up, we've got news, and we've got not headline news. We're going to get to that. A couple of the stories. Let me scan some of these. Oh, man, this is frightening. A record-setting venomous spider has... It's been discovered, and this thing is bigger than a baseball. And its venom, it is the most venomous, deadliest spider. And it was discovered by just some random dude. Not a scientist, nothing like that. Just some random dude was wandering around, and he found this thing, out in the wild. So we're going to talk about that. We also... if you don't have a New Year's resolution, we have a suggestion for you. And we have a story about science has found the best excuse to use if your New Year's resolution fails. All right, so that's all on the way. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle, trade in with us, and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community, Three Roads Brewery.
delivery.
There's nothing like holding a freshly grilled Jersey Mike's cheesesteak. It's even better than holding a winning $1 million lottery ticket. For starters, Uncle Sam takes half. Then you buy some useless stuff, like a tiny suit of armor for your cat. And before you know it, your sister's cousins and Uncle Frankie come knocking on your door for handouts. Bing, bang, boom, you're back to zero. So if you want to play a winning number, order a number 17 Mike's Famous Philly. Freshly grilled right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
This is not headline news. Today is National Whipped Cream Day. Remember, whipped cream is just like regular cream, except it can never hang out with the guys because its wife wants it to stay home and binge Married at First Sight. The Golden Bachelor got married last night during a live TV special. The bride wore white. Depends. Kelly Clarkson says she lost weight by listening to her doctor. Specifically when her doctor asked, "Want me to put you on Ozempic?" And California will require stores to have gender-neutral toy aisles. This means that boy dolls like Ken will share the shelf with girl dolls. Like Ken. This is not headline news.
It really isn't. It's the Mike Show. I'm so darned happy you could join us on this finally Friday edition of the program. All right, so I love this idea that this is anybody's go-to pub crawl. Members of something called the Disney Day Drinkers Club are upset after their mascot, a trash can named Benny, recently got relocated, okay, and they don't know why. And why would they choose a trash can as their mascot? We don't know. But anyway, the Disney Day Drinkers Club, or D3 for short, is a group of adult Disney fans who enjoy nothing more than going to Epcot and hitting up different bars around the park. They call it drinking around the world. So you might start with a margarita in the park's Mexico section, move on to sangria, and then so on and so on and so on. A former radio host in North Carolina named Skip Shear founded the club. It now has over 86,000 members on Facebook. But back to the trash can. Benny became the club's official mascot 2 years ago after someone was drinking on the sidewalk, which is allowed, by the way, and realized that Benny's flat top was a good place to set your drink down. And they like to joke that he's... Here, wait. I got this. And they like to joke that he's always trashed. Uh-huh. All right. So now club members are upset because the park keeps trying to move Benny to different locations. He's always been in front of a bar called Rose and Crown. Here, wait. I have a photo of this, and we can share this up on our Facebook live feed. Share screen, click on Facebook. No, wait a minute. Click on, where's the thing? Not this, not this, not this. Here it is. I found it. Sorry. All right, there. There's, and it's not like he's decorated. It's not like he has the name Benny, you know. It's just a trash can, right? But it's got a flat top. And it doesn't look like R2-D2 or anything like that. It's just a trash can. And then, now check out this guy's shirt. On the back of the shirt, it's him posing with a drink next to that trash can. And what does it say? Let me see if I can zoom in here. It all started with a trash can. There we go. So there's Benny. And there's one of the members. Is that the guy that founded it? I'm not exactly sure. But anyway, so it's been in front of the Rose and Crown. But last September, they moved him across the street to stop people like this from lining up and taking pictures and blocking the bar's entrance. Club members rejoiced last month. Rejoiced, I said. There we go. When Benny suddenly got moved back to to his original spot. Some people even bought plane tickets to go get a picture with him, but before they could get there, Epcot moved him again. So now, the future of Benny and where he will live is still very much up in the air. All right, that's your story of Benny. Let's, something else. Anything else? We said that. We did that. Do we want to do the venomous spider story during Nerd News? Let's do it during Nerd News. And then we'll also do Science Has Found the Best Excuse to Use if your New Year's resolution fails. But how about your resolutions anyway? Okay. It's New Year. It's a new year. It's the new year. The holiday insanity is over. And 2024 is basically a blank slate. And yet, people online are already back to complaining about their pet peeves, mostly regarding grammar. Yep, they're the grammar police. So, if you're a little loose with your grammar and you want to be more smarter, you can work on these things and shut those people up. Here are the main things that people are bringing up online. We got eight of them. Okay, let's do it from the bottom up. That's the way I like to do it. And, as always, mixing up there, and they are. Okay? So that's the number eight. That's why it said and, as always. Mixing up there, and there. Also, to. Like, if you're going to something or it's too much. I've got a friend who is a relatively smart guy, okay? And when he says, oh, these dogs are too much, okay, that's, think about, you know, when if you're saying it and you're stretching out those O's, it's two O's. It's not just one. And it's not T-W-O. But anyway, there, and there, they are. Saying nuclear instead of nuclear. Nuclear. Or familiar instead of familiar. When somebody writes people that instead of people who. Okay, these are some of the grammar police pet peeves. People using utilize where they should just be using use. Not utes. No, utes. Utes are young kids on the streets of New York. When people say on accident instead of by accident. People using whenever, like one word, where they should be using when. Like saying, whenever I was doing laundry on Tuesday. It's just when. When you were doing laundry on Tuesday. Mixing up prostate, which is a gland down there in men, and prostrate, which is a position. And then when people say irregardless instead of just regardless. I don't even think irregardless is a word. Is it a word? Let's Google this. Hit the Google. Irregardless. It's an adverb. It's non-standard. The photographer always says irregardless of how his subjects are feeling. Smile. This can't possibly be. Is it really? Okay, it's in the 19th century, probably a blend of irrespective and regardless. And somehow, it became a word. It's in Oxford, so I guess it's a word. I didn't even think it was a word. And then what's next? Oh, yeah, so yeah, you can work on your grammar and basically use that as your New Year's resolution if you want to. And then last, speaking of resolutions, if you're really fired up about your New Year's resolutions, good news. You could be paid to stick to them, and you can eat ice cream, too, assuming your resolution isn't avoiding ice cream. Halo Top Ice Cream is asking for applications for a so-called endorsement deal. They're hiring 10 people who will be paid $5,000. Mainly just for having a goal for the new year, sticking to it, and documenting their journey. You can apply on their website with a photo of yourself and a 30-second video explaining what your goal is and why it's important to you. It won't really work for things like saving money or cutting back on alcohol, but it doesn't have to be too extreme either. It could be anything tangible, like learning to surf or learning to play pickleball, walking regularly with friends, trying yoga, cooking healthier, or training to do, you know, 100 push-ups. I don't know. So if you're hired, you'll have to share 30-second progress videos for 8 weeks. They're accepting applications through Friday, January 19, and you'll have to be available to do it from mid-February into April. So there you go. If you want more details, go to halotop.com. All right. So irregardless of what else is going on? Okay. Coming up, we are going to get really, really smart with your five random facts. We're going to get even smarter est with your nerd news. And then we're going to get dumb with stupid criminals. So two smarts, one dumb. Okay. That is all on the way. And Riley, let's see, is Riley? Yes, Riley's going to be joining us from your Lynchburg Community Market. We'll get an update on stuff. If your resolution is to cook healthier, eat healthier, do all those things, Lynchburg Community Market is the place you need to start. Because I am telling you, the produce, everything that you buy there, number one, it's all local. Okay, so here, ding it off. It's all local. Okay, so you're supporting local farmers, local families, local makers in our community. All right, that's number one. Number two, the nutrition value of what you purchase at Lynchburg Community Market is going to be so much higher than anything that you could get at the grocery stores or the big box stores or Walmart, because the stuff is not sitting on a truck or a train car or whatever for weeks and weeks and weeks deteriorating. Okay, it was literally, some of the produce was picked that very same morning and then brought to market. Check out this segment. If your New Year's resolution is to eat healthier, if your New Year's resolution is to cook healthier, have just a healthier in general attitude, and also maybe it's shop local, maybe it's support local producers. Well, that's the place you need to start, and we'll talk with Riley all about that. That's all on the way. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by, speaking of resolutions, the YMCA of Central Virginia.
This is Ed. Ed loves the Y. Ed's buddy joined the Y because Ed told him how great the Y is. Now Ed and his buddy both save 20% off of their monthly dues. Ed and his buddy are getting healthy together. Ed refers his other buddies to the Y too. Now Ed and two of his best buddies are saving on their monthly membership. And you can too. Not a member? Join today with a friend and you'll both save like Ed. Be healthy, be active, be like Ed. Refer a friend to the Y and save.
How about this for a New Year's resolution? Invest in your home. Update that kitchen and bathroom with a visit to Stonecrafters. According to realtors, homes with updated kitchens and bathrooms sell 54% faster and for more money. Plus, you have to live there, and there's no greater investment, especially right now, than your own home. Stonecrafters has the largest selection of stone in stock, rows and rows towering throughout their factory direct warehouse. Plus, a great selection of remnants in stock, too, that can save you money. And right now, for a limited time, Stonecrafters will give you a free vanity top for your bathroom or bar with the purchase and installation of your new kitchen from Stonecrafters. Visit Stonecrafters for details. 3678 Manita Road in Bedford, StonecraftersVA.com. And they do it all from start to finish, from laser measuring your space, designing your project, cutting your stone right there in their warehouse, and installing your new kitchen and bathroom in days. For custom countertops and cabinetry, there's only one choice, Stonecrafters. Your satisfaction is guaranteed in Stone.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
Oops. Hey, Riley.
Yes. Sorry.
Oh. Hey, Riley.
Hey.
Guess what I forgot to do?
What?
I forgot to cue up the five random facts intro and music bed. So instead of, because I think this will work, instead of redoing it and sending you a new link, just you hang there. And here, I'm going to put some music on.
Okay.
All right. You hang there for just a second and let me move over to this machine where I'll cue it up. So we're live, though. We're on the air. So,
okay.
So stand by. Here, hold on.
Okay.
Hold on. My bad. I apologize. And okay. Here we go. And then this one. Okay. All right. So now, take two. That one's queued up. This is queued up. I need to stop the music. Stop the music. Okay, and now here, let's play.
And now it's time for
Random Facts.
Uh-huh. That time of the day. It's magic, I tell you. It's a magical time when we give you some important nuggets of information, usable information that you can share wherever the heck you happen to be. We don't know where you go or what you do. Quite frankly, maybe we don't want to know. But if you say any of these five random facts back, somebody in the room is bound to say,
wow.
Maybe, I don't know. All right, here we go. Number one, goldfish. You know, the actual fish, not the cracker. Goldfish were originally green or gray. The orange ones were a rare mutation. But those were very, very popular in China.
Hello.
Hi. So they bred the orange goldfish together, and voila. Number two, a few years before Samuel Morse invented Morse code, he ran for mayor of New York. His campaign slogan was, "No immigrants, no Catholics."
Oh, my gosh.
He lost the election. I don't understand why.
Yeah, shocking.
Number three, Paul Freevoices. He is the unseen ghost host who narrates the Haunted Mansion ride at Disneyland. He's also known as the Man of a Thousand Voices. His list of credits include Santa Claus and Frosty the Snowman. Number four, initially, this is wild. Do you remember the movie Animal House?
I don't think so.
Okay, all right. John Belushi, the actor who was the star of Animal House, he made less money for that movie than the horse in the movie.
Oh,
Here, hold on. Let's get the music back again. There we go. Yeah, John got paid $35,000. The horse got $40,000. John did get a bonus after the movie became a hit, but it's unclear how much money that was.
Oh my God!
And then number five. Quaker Oats was not founded by Quakers and has never been involved with Quakers in any way. They got their name because the company started in the late 1800s. And at the time, Quaker businessmen were known for their honesty. And those are your five random facts. It was basically marketing. It's marketing. It's all merchandising.
All marketing.
Merchandising. That's all it is. And so those are your five random facts. It's the Mike Show. Riley joining us from your Lynchburg Community Market. All right, and special. I might have a breaking news sounder.
Oh, even better.
Yeah, let's see if I can find it here. I didn't look it up, but here, right, breaking news. All right, there. Let's look for it. Here we go. Maybe this is it. Here, hold. Oh, you won't be able to hear it because I got the echo cancellation off, and I don't think anybody else will be able to hear it. Okay, maybe I have a graphic for this. Ooh, I might have a graphic for this. Let me see. Let me look at brand. Look at my Dropbox. Ah, here it is. I do. I have a graphic. Look at this. I got to download it, though. Did I already download it? I don't think I downloaded it. All right. I think I downloaded it. There we go. And then we have to upload it. Add video clip. Video stream use. Here we go. All right, I'm uploading the graphic. Oh, here it is. Here. Check this out.
Oh, live. Good.
Look at this. Look at that.
I like that. I like
it. Oh, yeah. I am loving this. We are so legit in 2024. We are so legit. Okay, breaking news. Breaking news. Riley, what's the breaking news from Lynchburg Community Market?
We are going to be closed tomorrow, December 6th.
Wait, no.
I know.
Yeah.
So all right,
January 6th.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, tomorrow's January, December. No, yeah.
Okay, so because of the impending weather.
Yes. Yeah, okay. The weather is calling tomorrow for a lot of snow and ice, and especially for where our vendors drive in from.
Yeah.
Way worse out there.
Oh,
so we're not going to take any risks tomorrow. We're just going to close for the day, but we'll resume next week.
Totally understood. So we were talking about a couple segments back. We were talking about New Year's resolutions. Hey, Darius.
Hey, Mike. How we doing?
Happy New Year.
You tell me I couldn't discreetly walk behind her without you seeing me?
I don't know.
I hear you, man.
I mean, he's like the Flash.
Yeah, he's so quick.
Zip in there and he's zipped out. Absolutely. All right. So we were talking about New Year's resolutions a couple segments back.
Yes.
And if your New Year's resolution is to get healthier, if your New Year's resolution is to maybe cook healthier, eat healthier, maybe it's shop local from local vendors. Any of those reasons could apply for going to Lynchburg Community Market.
It's true. That's the best place to go. Fresh
produce. Absolutely. Now, Darius and I talked about this. We talked about this ad nauseum, I think, for many, 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 many segments. But the way he explained it was, you know, your produce that you get at Lynchburg Community Market, rather than sitting in a truck for weeks and weeks and weeks, getting trucked in from wherever, okay, and they lose their nutritional value over time. The more time it sits on the shelf or in the truck or in the cooler, the less nutritional value it has. But the Lynchburg Community Market, these farmers, they're local producers, and they're literally, some of them are picking this stuff same day and bringing it to market.
Yes, that's correct. Yeah. So it's definitely a good place to come if you want to, you know, go on those New Year resolutions, eat healthier, shop local. It's a good place to start. Let's put it that way.
Absolutely. And you can start each and every Saturday except
tomorrow.
Please
don't come here tomorrow.
because of Snowmageddon. Snowmageddon. Breaking news. Anyway.
Please don't come here tomorrow, but you can come by today. Our gallery is open. All our permanent shops are open. We don't have farmers, but we do have all of our permanent shops, all our restaurants, and our gallery open in case there was something else you were coming to buy tomorrow.
Okay.
We're open today until 2.
All right. And even if the crafters aren't at Lynchburg Community Market, Riley or anybody there at Lynchburg Community Market that's working can they'll unlock a case or go get something for you, and they'll ring it up for you right at the register.
Yep.
So no worries if you're looking for something. Maybe you didn't get anybody something for Christmas and you're seeing them later on this weekend and you're like, oops, and you got to run out. You can probably find some pretty good deals, too. So, Riley, thank you so much. Where can folks find you on the interwebs?
We have an Instagram and a Facebook, which are both Lynchburg Community Market. And then our website is lynchburgcommunitymarket.com.
All right. There you go. Very, very simple. Visit lynchburgcommunitymarket.com. Stop by today, but not tomorrow.
Not tomorrow.
Snowmageddon tomorrow. All right.
Don't come tomorrow. You'll be very disappointed.
All right. Riley, thank you so much. Happy New Year. Hope you had a great holiday, and we look forward to seeing you at the market and talking with you again soon.
All right. Sounds good.
All right. Breaking news. Not tomorrow. Okay. Not tomorrow. Lynchburg Community Market is closed. Okay. Coming up, we are going to get really, really smart with your nerd news. It's this week in science. It's just science. And Riley, by the way, somebody found the most venomous spider in the world. It was not a scientist. A scientist did not discover the most venomous spider in the world. Just some random dude walking in the woods.
That's terrifying.
This spider, you'll have to stay tuned for the next segment, because this spider is bigger than a baseball.
Oh my God.
And it's the most venomous spider in the world.
Oh, and, no, thank you.
Yeah. And some random dude found him in the woods.
Oh.
We're gonna talk about that and so much more in Nerd News This Week in Science coming up. Riley, thank you so much for joining us, and we'll talk again soon.
Thanks, guys.
All right.
Join us down at the Lynchburg Community Market and experience all that one of the nation's oldest farmers markets has to offer. Grab some lunch from our restaurants and shops, or shop from our awesome selection of artisan, handmade goods in our crafters gallery. Swing by on Saturday to check out our farmers market, where you can shop from the freshest selection of local grown produce, meats, and more. The Lynchburg Community Market, located in downtown Lynchburg on the corner of 12th and Main Street. Open Tuesday through Saturday from 7 to 2 year-round. For more information, follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
Berg Burritos is back at Cafe Rodora, 1103C Church Street in downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg, with over a dozen different creations to satisfy. For breakfast, check out The Break, a burrito with bacon, scrambled eggs, tater tots, Monterey cheese, sliced avocado, and salsa verde. Or the Chicken Break Burrito, with adobo chicken, scrambled egg, tater tots, Monterey cheese, sliced avocado, and habanero barbecue sauce. How about the Steak Break, a burrito served with thinly sliced ribeye over scrambled eggs, provolone cheese, avocado, tater tots, and salsa verde. Each just $10. Order online for fast and easy pickup at RedoraSpecialty.com/cafe, or just Google Berg Burritos. Check out their menu and expanded hours for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Berg Burritos, inside Cafe Rodora, 1103C Church Street, downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF. All right, time once again for Nerd News. This week in science. It's just science. No need to be afraid. Covering the most important news for your brains. You may have missed. Here we go. Here's a quick rundown. We finally know why pee is yellow. A study at the University of Michigan, or no, University of Maryland, found that it gets its color from a specific enzyme created in our gut. When old red blood cells, that's me, old red blood cell, when old red blood cells get broken down, the enzyme is called, how do you pronounce that? Hey, wait a minute. Let's pop that up. How do you pronounce that?
Bilirubin.
Bilirubin? It's B-I-L-I-R-U-B-I-N, but it sounds like a sandwich. The bilirubin. Yeah, get the bilirubin. It's the best. It's got sauerkraut on it. All right. That's going to be the name of today's show, by the way. Bilirubin. Bilirubin?
Bilirubin.
Thank you. All right. Bilirubin reductus. All right. Number two on the This Week in Science. Color-corrected photos of Neptune showed us its true color for the first time this week. Experts thought it was more of a deep shade of blue, but it's lighter than they thought. Not a joke. And, by the way, they say it's just a tad less pale than Uranus. Okay. Let's see. Do we have a photo of that? Let's see. Okay, yeah, we do. Here, stop sharing that screen, and then we'll share this screen just so that you can see. Color corrected photos. There you go. It's a Uranus is on the left, and Neptune is on the right in this image. And they say, as I said, it's a tad less pale than Uranus. In other space news, the company Astrobotic is gearing up to launch its moon lander on Monday. And if you fill out a form on NASA's website, they'll put your name on the new moon rover that they're sending up there later this year. Interesting. What, are they just putting millions of names on a computer chip or something? Or are they going to get a big plaque? How are they going to do it? I have no idea. Anyway, in animal news, and we've got three animal stories here, at least. One's about older women that date younger men. Cougar news. In animal news, a study found humans can tell if a chicken is excited or upset based on the sound of its clucks. I think anybody that's ever raised chickens probably knows this. In cougar news, a study found older women who date younger men are happier and have better sex lives than women who date guys their own age.
Ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex.
There you go. Now, there was a great big huge spider. It is the most...
I said a great big huge spider.
Yep. The most venomous spider in the world has been discovered. It is a funnel web spider. Here, let me clear this out. Is this the picture of it? Okay. I'm going to share this up on our Facebook Live video feed right now. Go to The Mike Show VA to be absolutely positively terrified. This thing is bigger than a baseball. Yikes. It's a gigantic spider discovered in Australia. It's 3.1 inches from foot to foot, and experts say it's the largest known male funnel web spider that they've ever found. For perspective, the spider is bigger than a baseball, as mentioned. And if that wasn't bad enough, it was not discovered by a scientist out in the wild. It was not discovered by a scientist. Some random person came across it. They didn't say how that happened, so leave it up to your imagination. But you're walking along, and then this thing jumps out. I mean, at least it wasn't the...
No, not the beast!
No.
Not the beast!
No.
Ah! Oh, no, my eyes!
No.
Eyes! Ah!
It's very poisonous. Very, very poisonous. Funnel web spiders are the world's most venomous spiders. The venom is packed with 40 different toxic proteins, and its raw venom is the only way to make life-saving anti-venom. The spider here has been named Hercules, and he's living at a wildlife sanctuary in Australia now. The spider keeper there said Hercules has some of the biggest biggest fangs he's ever seen. And he can leap up, and he's got big fangs. Anyway, they will use Hercules's venom to create anti-venom. So just in case. What else? Is that it? I thought we had another story. I thought we had another science-y story. Here we go. Here, one more. Have you already abandoned your New Year's resolution? Well, you'll have to deal with the personal shame of it on your own. But scientists may have just figured out how to explain it to your friends and coworkers. Researchers at the University of London. There they are. Found that one excuse you shouldn't use is, I just didn't have time. When you tell people that, there's a good chance they'll respect you less and think that you just didn't try hard enough. So a better option is to blame external factors. For example, instead of saying you canceled your gym membership because you weren't going, tell them you canceled because you couldn't afford it. Okay. They found that I didn't have time, I couldn't afford it, are two of the most common go-to excuses for bailing on a resolution, and we tend to think that telling people we were too busy makes it seem, you know, like the importance or the status of a thing, you know, that fell below what we feel is important. Turns out, that's not what other people hear, though. Instead, they think you weren't truly motivated. If you were, you could have made it happen, no matter how busy you are, etc., etc., etc. But if you tell them you couldn't afford to eat healthier or join the gym or whatever, they might, probably say something like, yep, times are tough. Personally, I think it's a terrible excuse, but the University of London tends to think that it's a great excuse. And there's no excuse, by the way. If you join the YMCA of Central Virginia, our local Y, there are so many opportunities and there are so many grant opportunities and things that if going to the gym and joining the Y is important to you, and regardless of your financial situation, contact YMCA of Central Virginia, ymcacva.org, and speak with Misty, and she can get you plugged in to either a reduced rate or funding options that can help you based on your income. So there's no reason financially why you should not join the YMCA of Central Virginia. All right, a little commercial there. Plus, if you join now and you refer a buddy who also joins, you can save money. And, this ad, I think, will explain it a lot better.
This is Ed. Ed loves the Y. Ed's buddy joined the Y because Ed told him how great the Y is. Now Ed and his buddy both saved 20% off of their monthly dues. Ed and his buddy are getting healthy together. Ed refers his other buddies to the Y too. Now Ed and two of his best buddies are saving on their monthly membership. And you can too. Not a member? Join today with a friend and you'll both save like Ed. Be healthy, be active, be like Ed. Refer a friend to the Y and save.
All right. Coming up, we have sounds, and we are going to lovingly rehome them in your ear holes. It won't hurt. It's an outpatient procedure. We've got this. That's all coming up. Audio Vault is on the way. Plus, we're going to get really dumb with your stupid criminals in the news. That is all on the way. Stay tuned.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing community. Three Roads Brewery.
Getting a Jersey Mike's sub top Mike's way with onion, lettuce, tomatoes, oregano, and the juice is the bee's knees. Actually, it's better than the bee's knees. I mean, what's the purpose of knees on bees? They don't crouch, they just buzz around. But Mike's way has a purpose, topping your sub the authentic Jersey way. It's the cat's pajamas. Wait, cats don't wear pajamas. Mike's way is better. Let's just leave it at that. Get your sub top Mike's way. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF! Yeah, open it up. It's your audio vault for today. Our collection of bits and clips and viral audio for your ear holes. I think you may like this. Well, it's been a while since we've gone to Aaron Rodgers' neighborhood. I think he's ready to comment on the Jimmy Kimmel remark, don't you?
It was a beautiful day for a podcast. I was a guest on a show and looking for laughs when suddenly I dribbled something about Jimmy Kimmel. I accused him of being on Epstein's plane. My knee's getting better, but my mouth's pretty lame. It was quite an infraction. He threatened legal action. I have always wanted to be a TV talk show host, but I guess I should stick with the job that I love the most. So hopefully next year I'll be leading the Jets. That is, if I'm not under arrest. Excuse me for the scare, but I'm too rich to care. So won't you please forgive me? Won't you please forget the injury? At least you're not out for the season. Sorry, Jets fans. There's always next year.
Yeah, all right. Let's do this. Let's go to viral videos. And so there's a TikToker known as Tunnel Girl. And Tunnel Girl has been building a huge tunnel under her home near Washington, D.C. It's at least 22 feet deep. But her project just got shut down because she didn't have a permit. Oh, imagine that. Now she's waiting to see if her town will let her keep working on it. Here's a video she made before the shutdown. Her delivery is hypnotizing.
It's just been over a year since I started building my underground tunnel system. In August of 22, I cut an opening off the side of the sub-basement and started to carve into the solid rock. Fabricated an elevator to lift material, 1,000 pounds at a time. As the entrance tunnel stretched longer and deeper, I bought an electric yard cart and converted it into a mine cart. I used hundreds of concrete blocks and yards of hand-mixed concrete for the 30-foot entrance tunnel. Set up a blower and air duct for ventilation. There is still a lot of work left to do, but I am having a blast and enjoying sharing this project with you.
Uh-huh, me too. Anyway, the amount of work she did is actually incredible, but it's kind of cuckoo bananas. I mean, really. Anywho, all right, so the rest of this, this one, we're going to save that for stupid criminals. I'm doing nothing about the Golden Wedding and the Golden Bachelor. I'm over that. Do this. We wrap up Audio Vault with a comedian, and today is no exception. Since today is January 5th, it's National Bird Day. Here's comedian Nick Turner talking about how selfish bird owners are.
If anyone owns a bird, I should say, congratulations, first off. You're doing God's work. Because here's what happens when you own a bird, is you isolate the best thing about the animal, his ability to fly, and you rip that away from him! And you replace that with your conditional love. And then you jam it into a cage and you explain, I'm going to work, like forever. Goodbye, and you throw a blanket on it. And you're just like, yeah, he could be flying around in the sky, but I just feel more comfortable if he's in prison at my apartment. And you're like, I got a flight to catch. You remember flight? Play with the cat.
All right. That's your audio vault for today. Let's reach over here and lovingly grab the handle. Go ahead. Give it a tug. I dare you. There we go. Keep all that sound inside. Coming up, we are going to get so much more stupider with your stupid criminals in Dot News. This portion of the broadcast, though, is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike's Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy, because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea.
Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Hi, I'm Matt Bright, the new owner of CRI Digital Impressions. And I'm excited to announce a new chapter in the century-long history of CRI. Mutual Press was founded in 1927, and in 1973 it merged with CRI to become CRI Mutual Press. In 2002, it was renamed CRI Digital Impressions. I also own Bright Images, which has provided print and media services to the area since 1995. Yes, there is a new owner and a new location, but the same commitment to quality and service. In fact, quality and service are the cornerstones of my business philosophy. Quick turns and service with a smile. From business cards to banners and pamphlets to paperback books, we can provide all your printing needs. Call, visit us online, or stop by our location at 3022 Memorial Avenue, Lynchburg. We look forward to serving you.
Berg Burritos is back at Cafe Rodora, 1103C Church Street in downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg, with over a dozen different creations to satisfy. How about the Fo-Rito, seasoned deep-fried tofu, shaved ribeye and sautéed red peppers and onions, fried glass noodles, cucumbers, and bean sprouts with sweet chili sauce mixed inside. Or the Tort Burrito, a limited-time burrito with spicy deep-fried cheese tortellini, adobo chicken, red peppers, and house-made queso. How about the carnita? Slow-cooked pork carnitas with seasoned rice, black beans, shredded red cabbage, Monterey cheese, and corn pico. Order online for fast and easy pickup at RedoraSpecialty.com/cafe or just Google Berg Burritos. Check out their menu and expanded hours for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Berg Burritos, inside Cafe Redora, 1103C Church Street, downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry shops, Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at StonecraftersVA.com.
KHF. Right, time once again for Stupid Criminals in the News. I know that we're all sick of being asked to tip for everything. I mean, even at places that nobody is serving you. The servers aren't serving you. You're doing it yourself. It's all self-serve. But they say, do you want to leave a tip? Okay. So, but I think we can all still agree, tipping waiters and waitresses is something you need to do. All right? A group of 10 people went out to eat at a seafood place on Monday in South Bend, Indiana. It's called Wild Crab. And they had a scheme to try to avoid leaving a tip. Now, like a lot of places, the restaurant automatically adds an 18% gratuity for groups of 6 people or more. So the 10 people decided to split up into groups of 5, sat at 2 different tables, and pretended they didn't even know each other. It sounds like they weren't sneaky enough because employees caught on and added the 18% gratuity anyway, and that caused a huge fight. They demanded to speak to a manager. Then someone in their group pulled out some pepper spray, used it on the manager, and then used it on another manager while being kicked out. The restaurant called police to file the report. Paramedics treated the 2 people who got pepper sprayed. No word on any charges yet. A Nebraska man claims that his storage unit has been broken into 2 times now, and he had to close... And he's had to A Nebraska man claims that his storage unit has been broken into 2 times now, and he has had close to $75,000 worth of comic books stolen from him. Here is Chris Renstrom talking about the theft.
When I came down here, my lock was replaced and had a different lock on it. I could tell right off the bat because comics were moved. There were empty boxes. What seemed strange to me was everything was stacked, organized, but there were comics missing. I mean, it was obvious to me. Frustrating, anger, disappointment. Been collecting for years. It's personal to me.
Mm-hmm. The 2 dogs were caught after ripping up vehicles at a Houston car dealership. We told you about this earlier. They caused more than $350,000 worth of damages. Here are 2 of the dealership's employees, Gabby Fakorni, and Iman Hawk, talking about the dealing with the dogs attacking their vehicles. I can't wait.
Especially the brown dog was really the more aggressive kind of nature that that dog had. The black one was kind of follower. We are now going to start over a new year, 2024, with no fear of dogs.
We feel for these dogs, to be honest, but they're good now in good hands. So, you know, we don't have to worry about them right now. They can be adopted or whatever the situation they can do.
Okay. Now, one of the dogs has been cleared for adoption. The other is being evaluated to hopefully be cleared for adoption. And then there's this. A man was tackled by customers after jumping over the counter of a Starbucks located inside a Target store to steal a box of those pink Stanley tumblers. Here's the moment that he attempted to steal the cups and then was tackled by a customer.
Get him! Get him! Stop him! Stop him! Stop him! Look at this. This is insane. Look at this. He is insane.
Oh, man. All right. There is good news in the world. Yeah, Matt Hovey and I, when Linda Gentry, by the way, if you're listening or watching, hi, she posted on her Facebook page, what's the deal with the Stanley Cup? And so Hovey and I, we're big, you know, big hockey fans. So Matt left this real long comment about Lord Stanley's cup and how important it was and how it's the first blah, 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 blah. And then I posted a picture of the Pittsburgh Penguins hoisting their Stanley Cup win way back when. Well, anyway. I just thought, I don't know anything about the Stanley Cup other than what Matt was referring to. So I thought it was hilarious. Later to find out that it's something from Starbucks. Anywho, I digress. There's good news in the world, and we like to share that during this segment because there is so much stupidity. Workers who were remodeling an Atlanta movie theater found a 65-year-old wallet. Behind a wall that they took out, they were able to track down the owner, who is now deceased, and returned it to the family. Here's the owner of the cinema, Chris Escobar, talking about finding the wallet, and the owner of the wallet's daughter, Thea Culbreth Chamberlain, talking about what it means to her.
Once we started taking off the old tile, we discovered a little piece of the wall fell out right here in this corner, and then we see this space behind the wall that no one knew about. And that's when we discovered this incredible little historic find.
To be honest, mother losing stuff would not have been a surprise. It has meant more than I realized that it would, truly.
Yeah, I think this theater still has a number of stories to tell. You know, it still surprises us.
And there you go. That is the good news. All right, let's do this. Let's take a quick break. Back with Parting Shots. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by United Way of Central Virginia.
Well, being on the board is an amazing experience because you get to find out a lot about the community and what the needs of the community are. United Way is in the business of changing lives.
43,669 of our neighbors cannot afford the basic costs of living. United Way programs were able to provide 99,500 meals to families.
I am the change.
Visit our website, Be the Change, and donate today.
CV.org. All right, well, that is it. That is the program. We are back Monday.
Goodbye.
Don't come back.
No, we're back Monday with another thrilling and exciting edition of The Mike Show. Have a great day, great weekend. Stay safe with the weather. And by the way, quick breaking news update. Here we go. All right. Quick breaking news update. Lynchburg Community Market will not be open tomorrow due to the impending inclement weather. And not so much for our neck of the woods, but a lot of the farmers come in from areas that they're predicting that the weather is going to be a lot worse. So the travel for the farmers might be treacherous and dangerous, and they don't want to risk it. So Lynchburg Community Market closed tomorrow, but they're open today. No farmers, though, but they're open today. So if you need to pick up any gift items or whatever, or need to check out the restaurants or that kind of stuff on your lunch break, you can go there now, and they're open. But they will not be open on Saturday or Sunday or Monday. They'll be reopening on Tuesday, and then back with farmers next Saturday. So just FYI, breaking news. There you go. Well, that is it. That is the program. Thanks so much for joining us. Have a great weekend, everybody. Stay safe.
Thanks for tuning our way. And if you're listening in your car right now, thanks for the ride.
Scotty, beam me up.
So this is it. This is the end. I hope you and your companion had a good time listening. And hey, if things went really well, do me a favor and name the baby
Mike.
Ron. Ciao!
Ladies and gentlemen, the weekend.
Who's going to do the dishes?